Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at the acid-catalyzed cleavage of ethers. Ethers are relatively inert. They're generally used as solvents, but in harsher conditions, they can react. And in this case, we're looking at the cleavage of ethers with the addition of HX, so some kind of strong acid. So that will give us two equivalents of alkyl bromides in this particular case, and then water, which ended up being a leaving group. So here are my two alkyl bromides. Those come from the two sides of the ether. And then this oxygen atom that started out in the ether will end up in the water leaving group. So let's go to the next slide and we'll take a look at the mechanism. So the first step in this reaction is going to be to protonate the oxygen. Oxygen, when it's neutral, is going to be a poor leaving group. If it left, it would have a negative charge. And so that's unfavorable. That would give us really a strong base. So the oxygen is going to become protonated. We have a lot of strong acid in here. We have excess HBr in solution. And so that will give us this compound. Now, I'm using equilibrium arrows. It is an acid-base reaction, but really with the addition of excess of such a strong acid, you can push it towards the products there. So now I have this positively charged oxygen. It's analogous to a water leaving group, except we have an alkyl group on there too. On one side, I have a primary carbon, and on the other side, I have a secondary carbon. The mechanism is going to differ depending on the substitution of the alkyl group that the protonated oxygen is attached to. You're not going to see a primary carbocation. You will see a secondary carbocation. And in this particular case, we have a very good leaving group because the oxygen is positively charged and unstable. So this can leave in an SN1 type reaction. So we draw our equilibrium arrows here. So now I have this alcohol floating around in solution, and then I also have this carbocation that's formed. And then in solution, I have bromide, which is the conjugate base of that strong acid, and it's also my nucleophile. So the bromide that's floating around in solution is going to attack that carbocation. And again, reversible arrows for this SN1 type reaction. And that gives me one of my two alkyl halides that I generate at the end of this reaction. So this proceeded through an SN1 type mechanism. Now I still have this alcohol left, but since I have excess HBr, that's going to react further to give me the other alkyl halide. So we'll go to the next slide to look at that. So again, you have a poor leaving group in OH. If it left, it'd be hydroxide, which is a strong base and very reactive. So protonating this is going to make it much more likely to be able to leave. And that would give me this. In many cases, we use the equilibrium arrows to show acid-base reactions. In this case, we have a really strong acid in HBr, and we have excess of it. So we're really pushing the equilibrium towards that protonated form. Now, I've got bromide, which is the conjugate base of my acid, but it's also my nucleophile. And so now that can come in and attack, and this can get kicked off and leave. That's happening in one step because that's a primary system. It's unhindered and it's unlikely to proceed through a carbocation intermediate because that would be very unstable. And so then what I end up getting is my other alkyl bromide in this particular case because I used HBr, and then my water leaving group. So that is the acid-catalyzed cleavage of ethers. If you have an ether and you add HX to the solution, you can cleave off both of those alkyl groups to give alkyl halides, and ultimately water is going to serve as your leaving group. You can push the reaction to completion by using an excess of HX. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.